Jeff with Metalluminati, and I'm here with Frankie from Emmure. What's up, man?
How's it going?
Yeah, man, we were just talking about, like, you guys had to start out here in L.A.
Right.
And so, in order to get out here, you had to drive out here, book out here.
Yeah.
And so you guys set up a few shows on the way.
Yeah, so we were in New York City, where I'm from, and we all got together in the tour bus and started trekking west to the West Coast. And on the way, we played Knoxville and Memphis and Lubbock. And then we took a day off in Albuquerque, and then we just played a show in Flagstaff in Arizona, and that's it. So 8 days later, we're here. So, yeah.
Is it a good way to, like, supplement, you know, instead of, like, having to, like, basically fly all your shit and come out? It's better to just roll out and, like, pick up some guarantees along the way?
It's to help pay for a lot of things, like, you know, the bus costs, gas, shit we might need before we get to the actual tour. So, you know, it's all strategic economic planning.
Yeah, yeah. Is it just like a bitch to have to, I mean, does Mayhem require you to be on a bus and all that kind of shit?
Well, you don't have to be. It's kind of a luxury to be on one.
Yeah.
You gotta think really this, like, you only play like 3 shows a week, really, and then it's like 12-hour trip sometimes, stuff like that. So it's either like be in the sweltering heat and hate your life, or be comfortable and do an amazing tour. So
right.
I don't know which one you're gonna pick, but we're lucky that we can afford that. Yeah.
Talk about the big difference in cost between that, like, luxury and, like, sweating it out in a van.
You know, it's like you'll make an extra buck if you're in the van. You definitely will. But when you're like us and you have like a 10-person crew, you can't really fit in a van like that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it's a lot of different things. Like, we need a merch guy, we need a sound guy, we need our guitar tech, we need our drum tech. It's like the bigger your company gets, the more people you gotta hire.
Yeah.
You know, that's just how it goes. So make money to spend money, and that's what we do.
And how do you guys, like, focus getting, like, your tours and stuff? Is it like a self kind of thing, or do you guys have, like, tour booking management, or like a booking agent?
Yeah, we have an agent. We are actually booked by the Pantheon agency.
Uh-huh.
Our lovely agent's Amanda Fiore. Hello, Amanda. And, I mean, she's been working with us since, like, 2008, I'd say.
Do you guys start off, like, doing it all yourself, and then, like, you get to a point where you're just like, okay, it's time, it's worth it?
We've always been the odd man out in the industry, because for a long time, no one wanted to work with us, no one wanted to touch us. We got denied by every fucking label, every agency. Everyone was just like, nah, I'm not interested.
Why do you think that is?
I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know. And then once we started, you know, like, we just DIY toured and DIY released our music and all that shit for years and years, until finally someone was like, you know what, you guys are doing something. We want a piece of the action, you know? And that's just how it is. You know, some bands, you know, don't have to work as hard for something like that. But I think the fact that we earned every little piece of ground we've gotten, I think, is really what makes us appreciate this on a greater level. So
do you think that's kind of the way it is, though, now, like, with the industry the way it is? You really have to go out and kind of prove yourself now, and
I
then
mean,
even then you can, like, decide, hey, I want a record label or booking agent. You know, obviously with a booking agent, if to get to that next level, you kind of want that. But with the record label, it's kind of like a decision, you know what I mean? Hey, we're kind of doing this all ourselves, or hey, we want to, like, give it up, you know, like the
music industry is an enabler, you know.
Yes.
You know, with money and promotion and opportunity, you know what I mean? If you can just be some great artist, but if you don't have those enablers behind you, it can only amount to so much, you know what I'm saying? So it's all about how far you want to take it. If you're a kind of person who is completely fine playing bars on the weekend, then do that. If you're someone who really wants to make it their life and do it full time, like your job, then go for it. You know, it's not easy. You know, it's not, there's no red carpets, there's no bathtub of chicks and money.
It doesn't exist,
you know what I'm saying? But if you really want to make music and believe in what you're doing and do it full time, it's there waiting for you. You just gotta warn.
Do you think that's kind of the failure, though, of, like, a lot of artists? They still see that illusion of the rock star life that gets them in trouble before they've earned it.
I just think that now, because it's technology, internet, everything is so oversaturated that you don't have to work hard to understand how things go anymore. When I was a little kid, music was like, I can't, what, how, like, what, tour, like, what do you mean, like, on a bus, like, what is going on? Now it's like nothing now.
I
saw that band last week, I saw this band this week. It's like, you saw 10 shows this week, or what? How's that even possible? What are you talking about? You know, it's like, there's too many fucking bands, too many people trying to do it, and it's like, the oversaturation is what kills the grand scheme of it, you know what I mean? Like, we could be a band that exists for a long time and outlast bands, but just the fact that there are so many bands aiming for that, it makes it hard for someone to wiggle their way through. And we're lucky we came from a grassroots following before Facebook was big, even before MySpace was really a big thing. We were out there touring, doing it, you know? So, I mean, I don't know. Like I said, I have like a weird jaded view on it, because I think that a lot of bands don't understand what it really takes to work hard like that and like not just be like, oh, we're got signed. It's like, have you even fucking played a show yet?
Right.
And like, no, seriously, that really happens. Like,
right.
Have you even done a real tour yet? You got, what, you're in a 3-record deal? Like, what do you expect to happen? Who's in it? And the best part is that I know kids in younger bands who like tell me like, yeah, we just got signed. You guys have done one tour, so when your album comes out and your label drops you, are you really that surprised? You know, so you got to be smart about that shit. I mean, I don't know. Like I said, it's a metal blog for other musicians or whatever, but it's just, you know, I'm happy that we're a band that really worked what we got. So, yeah.
Cool, man. Well, thanks so much, dude.
Thank you.
Metalluminati, motherfuckers.